Thank you. brings you so close to your own death. And what brings such a frail little human to my dilapidated domicile?
What are you?
What is your name?
Catherine. My name is Catherine.
You're not one of them, are you?
One of who?
You need not fear me, Catherine.
I read what was in that file. So it's true then, you're a...
A victim, Catherine. Held here against my will. Experimented on like an animal.
I don't believe this. I can't.
Can't believe what is right before your eyes? As you said, you read their dossier, did you not? We could spend our time arguing the legitimacy of my existence vis-a-vis your magnetic refusal to believe. Or we could. We can help each other.
Survive.
What's happening out there?
What is happening? I just ran in here. I was on my way home from work. I wanted to get home to call my mother. She's been sick. She's been sick, and I wanted to see if she was okay, and I wanted to see if she could go to church with me in the morning. There were explosions, screams, lights. There were lights in the sky, wailing lights, all from above. I saw a group of kids running from a building that was on fire. There was blood on their faces. There were so many explosions. All the buildings were crumbling, and what is going on out there?
Indeed. The time has come, Catherine.
The time?
Yes.
The rats have overrun the kingdom. Now they must be exterminated.
You're dying.
You mustn't. So cruel. So intolerant. Oh, they were.
What did you do to those two men?
I did nothing to those men. Oh, no, I did nothing to those men. They were crushed from above. You can clearly see that, Catherine.
But they don't look the same as they did. And the blood on your... And I read what was in that file.
Imprisoned here for decades. The last of my kind. Why would I wish for this world to continue so the brilliant minds of your species can keep me here? Luxuriating in the excrement of my own loneliness?
They called your kind predatory. They said you fed on humans and drank their...
They have always thought such heinous things about us, Catherine. From time immemorial, they have sought to exterminate us. Because they feared us. Because they did not even try to understand us. We had our place in this world. We are as old as the planet itself. But your kind couldn't, wouldn't share that with us, or anything else for that matter. They have desecrated every square inch, eradicating life forms that have survived for millennia. Oh, they envied us. Oh. How you loathsome cunts envied us. But it was ignorance and fear that consumed them, controlled them, never realizing that all along it would mean their own demise.
I don't understand.
The blood in your veins is but a winter creek drying in the summer sun. You aren't the first to wander at the brink of extinction. Where it all went wrong. Fortunately, you'll be the last. At least the last that was birthed on this world. Catherine. one kind human to endure decades of hatred and torture and humiliation that your kind has inflicted on me.
Please.
Do you believe in God, Catherine?
I do.
Please. Come here.
Please. Please.
You'll find nothing in there to help you! It seems that we are tomb mates, Catherine. But unlike your Christ, you will not rise from here.
You know what's going on out there, don't you? Tell me.
I know many. Many things to all human. There isn't enough time left to even begin to offer you the depth and breadth of my knowledge.
Tell me.
And even if there were, your brain lacks the capacity to use it.
Tell me!
Things have run their course, Catherine. You would be doing yourself a favor if you would just let me kill you now.
Well, since I have nothing to lose, and nowhere better to be, try me!
Yours was always an amusing species. What do you want to know?
I want to know what you are, why you're here, why you're locked in that metal coffin, or whatever that is.
I've been imprisoned here for decades, being studied and interrogated by the brilliant minds of your military, while you, human maggots, struggle to cope with an extinction you can't possibly comprehend, much less stop. And only you dare to ask me to explain who I am.
No, really. I want to know. And since, as you say, I can't hope to save myself, then why not? Let it be the last bit of knowledge I glean before I am vaporized.
Oh, futile and illusionary. So human.
Perhaps. Well, what have you had to lose? Amuse yourself at my expense. With one last story.
Droll human. Maggot.
I think you can do better than that. I would think someone with your acute intellect be immune to such simplistic insults.
I could cast aspersions at you for 100 years and still not even scrape the surface of my disdain for your kind.
Now who's being droll?
So you're a smart one, Catherine.
Well, I was a philosophy major, and I minored in religious studies, only to find out that there's only teaching positions available in those fields. Apparently, I thrive on futile intellectual pursuits.
How well do you know your own homunculus history?
It's my favorite subject on Jeopardy.
Did you know? 14th century. The church decreed that cats were evil. It was their little glowing eyes and their penchant for traipsing about on their little paws at all hours of the night. What kind of creature practiced such behavior and had such unearthly features? Why, a diabolic creature, of course. The church ordered all the cats to be rounded up and destroyed. Burn the witches, destroy their familiars. And if they couldn't call the devil out,
why they would wipe his minions from the earth. And do you know what happened next? The rat population. They were free to propagate, and with the rats came the plague, which wiped out 1/3 of the human population. Your foolish ancestors saw no correlation. Nearly a century later, Pope Innocent VIII ordered all the felines destroyed. And again.
And you were there, though. Enjoy the show.
You humans, you've always been quite an amusing species. Always the architects of your own doom. Time and time again.
I don't understand.
Of course you don't! Maggot. So, you're ready then to grapple with your own history and accept it, regardless of all the light it casts upon all the delusional notions of superiority your race holds so dear.
If we're all to die, then I want to know why.
There were always those of your kind. A few who possessed more courage, who could face the truth. They were, of course, scoffed, derided by their less humble peers. Many assassinated. But I look at you, Catherine, and I can see a twinkling of their courage in your eyes. It was a different world, a different reality. You cannot begin to imagine the way the wind tasted then, the way the world smelled and felt to the touch. There was nothing that needed understanding. The world needed only to be sensed. Time did not exist. The need for numbers did not exist. No science, no logic, no currency, no religion. There was spirit in everything. But it didn't need to be debated. It just was. It is a reality that you could never understand, and I doubt you could even imagine it as it truly was. Before, when there were no words, no confusion.
But...
Yes. I know. I know what you're thinking. Of course there was death. But it was natural. A part of the tapestry of being. There's always been death where there's life. The intelligent creatures then understood how interconnected it all was. They instinctively knew the balance. They lived in a way that rejected and revered this interconnection. The
The planet was at peace within this natural construct. Life wasn't studied or questioned. There was mystery. There was wonder. And there was awe.
Were these creatures human?
No. 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 Oh, they came much later. There are creatures before your kind, similar yet different. In fact, I have yet to witness any species on this planet aside from my own that stayed true to its original way of being. Eventually, they always want more. For a snake to be consumed by a wolf is an honorable death. Humans have no honor. They fight with their hearts, not with their minds. Theirs is a legacy of thoughtless and brutal insanity. There's no relation to the law of nature in human destruction. Only humans endanger their own existence, desecrate the ground, the air, the water, and the precious life that it gives. Humans have polluted their own minds. Not just the lemmings, but the most powerful leaders, willingly deceiving themselves rather than face the horror they have become, all the while unable and ill-equipped to examine their reflections. And you call yourselves civilized.
What happened to them?
There have been many cycles on this planet. Many species who claimed themselves superior to all things while losing sight of their place in the tapestry of creation, their true wonderful insignificance. Like humans, they all rose up, evolved, climaxing into the states of arrogant inebriation, drunk with power, infested by delusion. My kind watched and grew to despise every one of them.
They? Who's they?
You think you know the ending to this story, eh? So typical of you humans, always rushing headlong to know the endings of stories. Never once savoring the beauty of the how and the why of the whole story. Your minds are overloaded with noise and chatter from your insidious gadgets and computers. The ending doesn't answer your question, Catherine, any more than the beginning.
Riddles.
No, no. No riddles, human. Only truth. And truth is rarely ever as succinct as you want it to be. Especially if that the truth cannot be easily grasped by the simple-minded.
Then tell me how they perished. Was there a cataclysm of
evil event?
You have the time for me to recount the many extinctions I have seen. The reasons are as varied as the stars, but they all share the same result. You humans have lasted much longer than I would have ever thought possible, much to your credit. But, like all others before you, you are blind to your own reflections. And how wonderful for me to watch your kind evolve into frenzied rats, lost in a maze of your own creation. This time, the effects of your abominable yet short tenure are far more profound. The cycle will run its course. You humans have been a surprisingly adaptable parasite.
Of course, I imagine.
There was some hope at the beginning that you would prove to be the greatest of life forms, that you would harness your true potential spiritually, biologically, intellectually, bring the Earth back to a pure state.
I imagine those souls of yours are quite intriguing to them. They are quite advanced. Even my kind could see that. No wonder they had hope for you. But of course, your kind did nothing of value in the end. Quite the contrary. Regeneration. Similar to your sleeping. Pardon me.
So, what does any of this mean to you?
Believe it or not, I too detest much of what my race has done. But unlike you, I don't think we are hopeless maggots. I believe in a higher power.
Ah, yes. God.
Jesus is my heart and soul.
Jesus? What do you mean? The Zoroaster? Or Mithras? Or the one before him? Jesus. The greatest delusion of them all. Just ask Constantine about Jesus. For Christ's sake.
I believe in God.
What are your most desperate intentions?
You don't know anything about God.
Oh, your insidious and boring delusions.
My faith is not a delusion.
Oh, you invented God because the knowledge of nothingness beyond was far too much for you to bear. You have no real connection to the source of eternal creation. No connection to yourselves. Let alone the true order of the cosmos. The ever-expanding source that is nothingness. Everything and nothing. But things will run their course. The fate of your world rests in the hands of
survived for so long. How have you adapted?
Your scientists have never understood our adaptability. After all the years I've been in prison here, they've not cleaned one thing. All the while exhibiting the ability to acknowledge your inherently destructive behavior, let alone repair it. Hold the illusion at all costs, knowing that there is no real solution. No hope. No hope to stop the madness you have cultivated for so long. The destruction of your own lives, and what's more, endangered life beyond the Earth is utterly pathetic.
I can't justify anything they've done to you or your kind. Until today, I never really knew you existed.
Yet, like them, you fear me, Catherine. You abhor me.
I'm not scared of you.
Don't patronize me, Margaret Breeder! With all your technological and scientific prowess, you're just a tribe of apes. Huddled around a dying fire. Eyes wide with terror from the noises of the night.
Perhaps you've misunderstood.
Human, if I were not sitting here in this crippled state, I would snap your spine for your glib and flippant delusions. Your God systematically wiped mine from the face of this world. It was genocide.
And only I remain. Not much fun! All I want is to return. I just want to return to the void. Oh, the all-encompassing void from which my guide came. However, at the moment, my options are a bit limited.
You're flesh and blood. Biologically, you're not that different from us. I read that in your file. Your healing capabilities are stronger. Your organs and bones more resilient. But genetically, you're not that far removed.
Like this, like you in form, walking, talking, consuming, defecating, we came from the ether, born with the first light on this world. Let's just say, it was more convenient for our needs.
Of the souls we possess, are they not enough to warrant a stay of execution?
Souls. It was merely a figure of speech. They call them containers because you're all living on borrowed time.
Well, I believe in the soul.
Yes.
What did you think about in here while you were imprisoned?
Nothing.
Nothing at all, human. You couldn't possibly understand the sound of nothing. So soothing. What would you ponder, Catherine, if you were encaged in a steel canister for decades on end? What did the last mastodon think as it roamed the great plains in search of food that no longer grew? Watching the stars. Brilliant.
So that's it then? Everything ends? I die, you die, the whole course of life on this planet simply returns to dust?
This is not the first Armageddon. I will remain.
I know your kind can be killed.
Yes, we can be killed, but we cannot die. Your kind once understood this as well. I have no fear, Catherine. Your flesh, your minds, your entire legacy will be erased like it never happened. And your souls, well, they'll be recycled, but I will remain. Ah!
they left for you out in that desert beneath the pyramids. And you're still a race of medieval witch hunters.
Nightmare.
hope that they could unravel the mysteries of my longevity and regenerative abilities. They wanted to learn how to fuse my DNA with theirs to create a super race that they could one day rise up against them. To rise up against the gods that would return to destroy them. But Catherine, I know the way. I can make us, you and I, into that super race. You and I, Catherine. You and I can build an army. There's still a chance.
As bad as we are, as evil as we can be, we always have a choice. We can choose to rise above our ignorance, our savage impulses, no matter how commanding they may be. And that is what I call the soul.